So, good evening, Vamsi. First of all, thank you. I've been a big fan of Talk to Tiger right from the start. I've been watching and been very inspiring. In fact, we worked on some of the campaigns also for Talk to Tiger. I distinctly remember the Tata Steel campaign where you had the honor to interview the Vice President of Tata Steel at that point of time. I think that was one of the highlights of my career as well. So, obviously, because we don't get such a chance, and it's been always a pleasure to work with you, obviously. I mean, there are some people who are really looking forward to work, and you are one of them always. So
Thank you.
I'm really honored to be in Talk to Tiger today. So
Thank you.
brief about me. Pardon?
For my audience, introduce yourself.
Yes. So brief about me. Accidentally, around 12 years back, I landed up at a company called Blogata, where a programmer eventually turned into a content marketing specialist, eventually to an influencer marketing specialist, and that's what my career has been till now. Today, I am working with one of the top marketing communication firm called Blue Ocean, which is into basically enabling growth for partners. That is what we try to do. And we try to bring in the various terms and technologies to help you do that. Thankfully, throughout my career, I worked with the best of people and continue working with the best of people. That's what it is. And very, very privileged to have worked with some of the best influencers at the start of my career. Because at that point of time, if I look back, influencer marketing was very, very niche and people are very about it. But at that point of time, I could work with people like Vamsi, Gigi, and a lot of other people. Yes. So that is what it is, and that is my story. Vamsi.
To give a brief about Harish and how do we know each other. So Harish was one of the top people to lead India's blogging scene. Well, very few people actually knew about blogging. Harish and his team with Blogata and several other people was actually talking to brands, helping people, influencers like me and many others, monetize their blog, improve their content. They ran contests, encouraged and motivated them. So this was he was at the forefront of all the revolution. So today I requested Harish to join us to help us understand how social media influencers will have to adapt in the next 10 years. So over a period of next 10 years to 2030, what do we do? So we feel we are old because we have been in this field for more than a decade. So Harish, I was recently reading an article where Amazon and these Prime and these people have reported that more than 3.5 hours every day people are watching when compared to 2 hours before. So people are spending time on consuming content, and that has gone up by close to 80 to 90%. So as a social media influencer and brand, what are people thinking about this? How does it change the industry?
See, I think the last 2 months have drastically and dramatically changed how we are consuming content and the time we are spending online. Just to give an average, it was about 6 hours on an average, including all platforms plus Amazon Prime and everything to a day. Today, it's if you add 1.5 hours, 2 hours traveling time for a lot of cities, you're adding that kind of time spent online. We are seeing the increased number of Zoom downloads, house party downloads. People want to see the fundamental of human evolution. People cannot stay alone. They have to connect, and there has to be a medium to connect. When you cut off the offline medium by social distancing and COVID, there is only the medium left, which is online. So people have started consuming a lot of stuff online. And this is going to go for a minimum of a year or two until we find the vaccine. So that is going to happen for sure. The idea here is the kind of content and the share of voice that we'll have to work, because each one of us has an attention span, and what interests me may not interest the others as well. So the challenge for a content creator and a brand today is, how do I invoke the interest in my consumer's mind today among the hundreds and millions of things he's seeing every day?
So you're saying travel time reduced, but people are still keeping up the content. In fact, it increased consumption, is it?
Absolutely, absolutely. I mean, super increase in consumption, because you have nothing to do now. you have to stay online, work from home, and the freedom of probably streaming something while working was not there in office for a lot of offices at that point of time. But today you can also have stream Saavn and Gaana or whatever while working, so that also increases. So we are seeing a lot of data consumption being increased tenfold here.
So the average consumer today is about 29 years old, is the average age of Indians. That means that we are one of the youngest population when you compare to 40 years in China. So do you see any change in the way people are looking for content?
Absolutely. The biggest example is the rise of TikTok and all the Chinese apps. Go. I cannot count them. I mean, those kind of apps have come where every day if you play, do you play Ludo, Vamsi?
I sometimes offline, not
online. So good. Okay, so when you play online Ludo, one advantage is you get to know which sort of brands, shady brands which are promoting via Google Ads. That's when I come to know that okay, there's a new network which has come in, which makes you meet people via live video. Mm-hmm. And you have the shady photos of live video coming there. So Chinese apps have just taken over because they are attending the rural mass, and rural mass want good content. People make fun of TikTok content saying, "Hey, what is this? This is a classy content. Where is the content quality?" But the fundamental of a human is, you and me, when we started blogging also, what is our objective? That people come and visit our website, correct? And people validate what content you have written. The same way in TikTok and all the platforms today, people want validation for the content that they're creating. And TikTok and other platforms make it easy for them, as simple as that.
So you're saying there's a definitely a change in the way people are looking at content. And so isn't it shorter? What is attention span according to you?
Oh God, don't even ask. It's reduced to 15 seconds for me now.
15 seconds.
Thanks to Instagram stories.
So is the content good now or it was good 10 years ago?
Definitely 10 years ago. Okay.
So, but the consumption is increased. So you're saying, what do you predict in the next 10 years to come in terms of time of the content? Duration.
As you rightly said, the 29 years indication of the age also makes you understand that we are, the younger generation is very impatient. They want things to come on the go as fast as they can. Be it money earning. So today, if it is 15 seconds for me, tomorrow I won't be surprised that it will become 5 seconds. I mean, that is a decrease. You have two options. There was a time when you used to long read. I mean, 500 words ka blog post was a norm today. But today, you tell me how many people are reading such blogs? Very few. I mean, only people who are very interested and fond of reading are reading. People have stopped reading books because they say, "Arey yaar, I cannot read so much. I don't have the mental capacity to do it." But you can binge watch a series.
That is true.
So the consumption is shifting. The medium is shifting, but the patterns, the key pattern that is emerging out of this is, you have to constantly hook your reader or your visitor to good content. You cannot even be complacent there for a second, because if that attention goes, then the entire thing goes.
So you're saying that the content quality can improve and it has already improved, so that people are trying to condense it.
When you have more competition, the better content has to emerge out. So that is visible here. Let me take you to an example of a series called Asur. It comes in boot. Arsad Warsi, and now that content, no one would have heard of boot. Netflix, Amazon, Hotstar, these are the three players. Boot is somewhere there, but it's not mass. But that content has become so good that people are talking about it, that people are going to boot to just watch that series. Now that is the power of content.
Good content. So what
very good content.
What are brands looking at? from influencers now. So 10 years back, it was just take my name out or tag me, tweet about me. That was what was the story. Right now, is there any change? Are they more broader in the requirements?
I think a lot of brands have got smarter, and thankfully I am able to work with such brands. For example, a brand called Victorinox that I work with, I really enjoy working with them because they understand and they are willing to take the risk. For example, we did a campaign 3 months back, January, sorry. In that, we created an offline campaign where about 15 influencers from across India came, did other activities using the Swiss Army knife, and the content which came out of it was amazing. To an extent that globally, the brand headquarters liked it and shared it with other countries, saying that this is kind of the best thing to create. So the best part is, if the brand would have not agreed to this content, this content would not never have been created. Mm-hmm. So the brand is willing to take the risk, and they are saying that okay, let's try this and let's go ahead with it. So I had to give importance. The due credit to the brand manager as well, because vision has to see the day.
Really?
If not, it doesn't make sense.
So you're saying brands are looking at much, much wider, wider participation and engagement than just a tag or a mention in the social media.
Today the brand has to be holistically included. It should not look like it's a completely paid campaign. Today the audience has evolved so much that they understand what it is and what it is not. What is a paid campaign, what is not a paid campaign. So smart integration is a key.
Okay, I lost it between. You're saying smart integration?
Smart integration of content is the key.
Okay.
I mean, it cannot be just the old style where you talk about it and blatantly promote a brand. No, today if you do that, you'll be identified very easily, and the value ROI will be very less.
Mm-hmm. So for a fresh influencer, someone who is starting out now, let's say 18, 20 year olds who are starting out in the market, what are the 10 things they can do in the next 10 years so that they'll raise to a place where they'll withstand the competition? And I'm talking to you in two perspectives. One is, you already are working with superb Instagrammers. I know people like Haram Kaur. There are many people who are chefs. Recently, you posted one. So these people have built a huge database, right? They already put out so much content. So for them, I can't reach that. For example, if I start today, I can't reach it. But someone who is a 20-year-old, 10-year-old can build a brand and reach that. So what is your advice to influencers who are starting just now?
Once to be very honest, we cannot trade for 10 years because Instagram rose 3 years back, very honestly. And today we have newer platforms also coming in. So we really don't know what is going to happen 2 years until in terms of platforms. But I think the ground rule remains that consistent, good quality content is what you need to churn out. And don't worry about the numbers at the start. The biggest fallback any influencer or a content creator does is he starts getting disappointed, saying that I'm not getting the numbers like others. Why should I continue doing it? No. If you believe that your content is really good and the content is going to provide value to a person, you have to continue doing it and you will get the value for it somehow or the other. Patience is a key. If you're not going to be patient and say, okay, within 3 months, the viewership is, I just got 500 followers. Am I doing it right? You get disappointed, you stop. No. There's a lot of challenge today. So the time taken to get noticed is very, very difficult. But just imagine once one post or one content piece is just enough for you to get noticed. Once you get that done, even Haram Kaur, for example, that WHO post which he did on Juhu Beach was a game changer for him. Where he got featured and where Instagram feeds. So a lot. That one post is enough for you to change the world. So don't get disappointed. Keep churning out good content and don't worry about the results. Yeah, keep getting the feedback from people on how to improve, what to improve. That is very important. You need to evolve. You cannot be stringent saying that this is my style, I'm not going to change. You have to evolve with times.
So you mentioned, I agree with you about the content part. The secret for anyone is not to look at external satisfaction. It's about you putting out content, improve your style, learn new techniques and put out. So that's what exactly what I feel. And also have the consistency like Harish mentioned. So it doesn't matter when you'll click, but there is definitely a chance that if you do it, it's just like cricket, right? You play every day and you improve your game. And one day you will be a Virat Kohli or you'll hit a century that people will look out and watch out for.
No, guy, of course, Vamsi, do you remember the videos which Giri took in Goa when he did the stop motion live or your thing? At right. That point of time, he didn't have Giri's on the Seri or anything around tech at that point of time.
Right.
Today, I'm really happy and proud that man is doing a lot in terms of videos.
3 lakh follower.
Yeah, absolutely. And there is a follower, there's a hashtag Giri Sonna Siri. Did we ever imagine at that point of time that Giri will know? But he had that passion. He was the only group at that point of time where you, me and him and others created that video in the live at that point of time. He had the knack, the fire.
Correct.
He just had to keep pushing. And your talk to Tiger was a similar thing where you were recognized because of the content. Otherwise, why would a Tata Steel vice president give his interview to anyone? You were chosen because your content was really good and you had that base.
True. Thank you. That happened because of you, but...
No. It's always you, sir. It's always you.
Okay, we'll move on. So, you mentioned, calmly mentioned House Party people are downloading. So, what are the latest platforms that one should be on? For example, TikTok.
I can't hear you properly.
No, you mentioned some platform saying House Party download. House Party you mentioned, right? So, what are the other platforms people should watch?
Yeah. See, House Party is more about connecting. But in terms of content, what I'm betting big on is Firework, which is a new platform where you can do both landscape and video, portrait, photography and video. Very interesting platform. And it is being promoted now by Sameer Nair, who was at All Balaji before, and who's taken over the CEO route of this. So very interesting. So you just check out Firework.
Okay.
Pardon?
Firework.
Yeah, Firework. There are some interesting content players who have come there as well.
Okay.
So I think that's a very interesting concept.
Okay. Other ones? Like, what is your idea about TikTok? TikTok, caffeine, stream it.
See, all these platforms that are loyal or the audience base, they will keep on churning good content. But I'm sure that there will be a saturation point, like we saw on Twitter and Facebook, when people moved on from there to Instagram and Snapchat and now TikTok. So, see, we just have 24 hours. That is not going to change. How in 24 hours we are going to use our time and these platforms are going to use our time is will be the key.
So, I understand a lot of brands right now which are in hospitality, travel, things like that are not able to promote their content because no one is buying. But there's, I saw a sudden shifting in their voice where they started talking about social issues. Supporting issues, how they take care of their employees, focus about be home, stay safe, things like that. So is this a good, with Corona effect being, I believe it will be there for 2-3 years more. So what do you think about the social causes or what are brands saying? What is there a change in voice?
See, at the moment brands, some brands are not very clear about how do they communicate, but they have to communicate. Because this was an unexpected event which has come on us. But in the background, they are evolving. They are thinking about how do we get more. Because that's a challenge every brand, mall, travel industry is going to face. We have to evolve. World, as yesterday the PM said, we cannot stop. We have to evolve and move on. So in terms of evolving and moving on, how do we get the measures to policing? Like for example, today, I saw a video 2 days back in China where every school person has a set of 5 things to do before that schoolboy enters the school, which also includes a live testing of coronavirus before he enters the school. So you never know. I mean, once you know the if you're getting a test in about 1 hour, people may just take a ready test, take the test, go out and say, okay, this is my test, I am free, let me come for shopping. So people are evolving. You cannot really predict on what is. See, it's going to take a hit as well. But if you read the news, 2 days back, I read this news saying that the Carnival cruises have got about 600% increase in requests. Now, which is a very, very, very surprising thing, because maximum hit was in the cruises across the world for coronavirus. But people are still going and thinking that, okay, once you start, I'm going to go on a cruise. So you never know. I think Vamsi, what is happening is it's culture specific and country specific, to be very honest. Like, I have my friends who are staying in US and saying, "Arey, last week we went to this national park, got some good photos, and came back in a Ford Mustang." Okay, and here we are not. I'm not able to take my car through 4 kilometers away because there's social distancing and police here.
Correct.
This is the kind of challenges everyone is facing today. So there's no new world order. It's going to evolve country wise and culture wise, and how people are ready for it is how it will change.
So what are your top 3 tips for social influencers? This is the last question. What are your top 3 tips for social influencers, whether it is existing or new? Next 2 years, let's say, you said 10 years you can't predict, so 2 years.
The first thing is identify a very clear niche in terms of content. What is the topic or a need that is missing today, and are you good at it? If you're good at it, yeah, you found the magic potion. Start creating content for it. Point number one. Point number two. Please be really patient, because the challenges for getting notice is much more than what it was before, since a lot of people are there online. So you have to wait for your star moment. Until then, keep creating good content. And platform. And the point number three is, it's so important that people understand that there is a lot of effort being done for creating good content. So there has to be a consensus in terms of the value for content created, which is still missing in the market. So for a new person, I think he or she has to stand the ground right from the start of the career, saying, this is what my value is, be it even 10 paisa, that's okay. Just giving a hypothetical figure. But there has to be a figure. He or she cannot go into a field saying that I'm working with X brand for 10 paisa and for Y brand for 5 paisa. So then, as a reputation, it's a hit, which a lot of people did at the start about influencer thing, because people didn't have a clue and everyone wanted to grab the moolah. There was no professionalism. So I think the professionalism has to come.
So the 3 tips Harish said was, one is be consistent, start putting out content, identify a niche for yourself and then push there, keep content there. Second, like you said, I also believe that you should have respect for yourself. Respect meaning make sure content is good and make sure that there's a quality that other people cannot provide. So if you don't have quality, regardless of the number of posts, number of followers, it doesn't matter. It's about the respect that you have. So people who are coming to read your content or watch your content, you should respect their time and provide value for that. If you're adding something, great. So what we are looking at is a difficult time, like Harish said, different cultures, different countries, and different people have their own response, but we are going to come out of this. And when we come out of this, brands will again come and watch our people who have been consistent with their content. And also watch it for firework. I have never seen that. I will go and check it out now. Harish, one last question about job opportunities in PR. This is a difficult time. Many people are cutting budgets. What do you think about job opportunities in PR?
PR is something which I would not comment, because that's not my field. But digital marketing, influencer marketing is my field. And I'm sure the opportunities are really good there. And because more brands will come into digital today than what it was before. And need for becoming digital is much more than what it was before. You can see the example of the farmers out of Bangalore coming into apps and selling the produce directly to consumer. So that's one new opportunity which has been created. So like this, a lot of brands, smaller players will come for digital, and that's where a digital marketing person has to be there. So I don't see a fall in digital marketing job opportunity. It's just going to increase.
All right, on that first note, we'll take a break. So thank you, Harish, for joining us today. It's been really a pleasure to talk to you. Hope our viewers are able to understand that this market is not going anywhere. Many people are joining social media. People who are not conventionally on social media are joining. So if you have good content out there and nobody has recognized you yet, keep posting, keep writing, keep creating content. Someday your time will come. Like Hari said, we'll
superstar. Apna time aayega. Apna time aayega.
All right. Thank you, Harish.
Anytime, Amshi, for anytime.
Have a good day.